So if we will replace this dot with comma, so you can see an error would come to the screen. You can see they are showing, you can make sure whether you are doing any type of error in this. So here are the some common errors which we should avoid. Welcome to another video tutorial. In this video, I will show you some common errors which occurs while performing any analysis using this SRPlot website. So first of all, let me tell you what are those common errors and how you can avoid them. So the first error, whenever you try to log in on this website, and as you know, this website is bioinformatics.com.cn/en for English version. And the first thing which you should make sure that you should log in before using this website. And if you don't want to log in, you can use this test account, but I would recommend you that you can sign up using your own email, because as its sign up is totally free. And after second thing which you should notice, that if here are points zero, so you need to email to this email account, and you need to ask that I am new user and can you please give me some points. So hopefully they will give you 50 points for free, and here most of the analysis do not take any point, but few heavy analysis consume only 1 point. So if your points are zero here after login, so you can please go to this email ding@bioinformatics.com.cn, and you can request them that you need points for your analysis for your research. And although they are asking for donation to support this program, but even if you cannot donate, no problem, you can just email and request them, they will give you for free. And next thing are the common errors which occur while the data format. So whatever analysis you want to choose after you have login and make sure you have enough points. Let's suppose you want to perform any analysis like 2D pi, gene up down bar or cluster heat map. So whatever you want to perform, you can simply click on this. So as here you can see, here we need to input our data. So before that, any analysis, whatever you want to perform, you can go to click on that analysis, and you can go here in this input example. So here is one input example. So we can, you can see here is that one example. So if you want to draw your heat map, so you also need to format your data in the form of this. Here you can see the first, we have actually three groups. So you can also write and format your data according to this. And next you can see we have the same group name AA, and next we have the next group, and here are its technical replicate. So you can also design your data. So if your data will not be in this format, so of course this SRPlot website is not going to draw heat map for you. Another thing, that these groups name, you can see here are the some names. So if there would be any name repeated, so of course it would not generate any graph, so it will give you an error. So make sure here the gene names are unique, I mean any name should not be repeated. And here one thing more, you can see if there is 5.7, so if we will only change it with comma, if there would be comma in between, so it will give an error. So let me show you, like here if we just copy this and we will paste into that website, you can see when we have used the exact format, so it will generate heat map. You can see here heat map is generated. So if we will replace this dot with comma, so you can see an error would come to the screen. You can see they are showing, you can make sure whether you are doing any type of error in this. So here are the some common errors which we should avoid. So first we should make sure that we are reading the instructions and examples, because I know students are in hurry and they want to perform their analysis. They usually don't read these information. Although you can see here they have given the information like how to input data. The first row is actually the group name. The second row is sample name. You can see they are telling about this example. You can see this is the first row, and next they are telling about the second rows, and they are also telling. So I must recommend you can read all this information. So the next common error, point as decimal separator. So you should must use point here. You can see if there would be any comma here, so of course an error would occur. So you cannot also use some special characters like alpha and percentage and some. If there would be like character in Chinese, so it will give you error. So the next is upload the file format. So if you are using XLSX format, you can see here we have different options. We can also upload data here and we can also paste data here. I would recommend you can directly paste. But if you want to upload, you need to make sure your data is in the form of text file, .txt file. And you also need to make sure your file is less than 25 MB. So if your file is greater than 25 MB, so it would give you an error. And you also need to make sure there are few case sensitive, like if you want to calculate log FC, so you must need to write log FC like, you can see the LOG are in small letter and F and C are in capital letter. If in this format, these header name and some formulas are like case sensitive, so you must need to take care that you are using this one. And here is an important thing to consider, that we should use unique ID. Like if your data is in the form of this, you can see in this group, XX is going to be repeated, so it will give you an error. So what is the right way? These names should be different. Like this is the first one is X and the next one is Y. Next is the same column number and order. You can see the order is A, B, C, and next is X, Y. This is right, but here you can see the X is going to be repeated, so it will give you an error. Next, one thing important, if your this first row and first column is empty, so it will also give you an error. Make sure there is something written, whatever you want to write. So this first row and first column cell must should be filled like this one. Next, with the header line. So whenever you are going to copy your data, so like if you want to draw a heat map, so you cannot only copy this, because you also need to copy this header information along with this other data while pasting. So you need to also copy your header line. And the next one is the missing value RNA. So if there is some missing value, you can write 0 RNA. So if you will directly paste as such, so it will give you an error. So here is no new line within the data. So here you can see there are the two words X and Y are together in one cell. So they should be actually in the different line. So if they would be in the same line, so it will give you an error. So here are the some common errors which you can take care while performing analysis using this SRPlot website. If you still found any problem, so you can email to the administrator of this website, that is ding@bioinformatics.com.cn. If you are still facing any error, please let me know in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.